stick a blade right through their skull. Isn't that a nice way to start a video? Hey everybody, Cypherboy here, and I am playing The Walking Dead No Man's Land. So I'm going through the first battle here with Daryl in my... not in my team, but he's on the sidelines, like, as a guest character. And my people are just going through the walkers. Get ready for trouble. This one is just pretty much showing you what to do for the battles. So if you do play this game, you'll probably notice the music isn't the same as what's on the app, and that is because I used my own music. So I chose something that would, or a couple of them that would, I think go well with the game. And here we are, we won that one. What a mess, everybody's dead and the camp's yours if you can rebuild it. Maybe there's some supplies around you can salvage. Build a farm plot. I should have seen if I could have moved that around, but I didn't. I was too lazy to do that, and most of the time these kind of things won't allow you to, so I figure just go through and do what they want for now. I do move things around later on when I buy some more things. We gotta go back to Terminus. Road to Terminus. Unlock Daryl with the little token things. Okay, there we go. We all have to fight our way back. Swarms, the road swarming with walkers. I can't talk right now. Royally, messed that one up. I should have drank some water before I started recording. Good thing this thing has a pause, so I can do that if I need to. And here we're just waiting for some, waiting for the loading screen. So Daryl is back in Terminus. And these three are people he had saved from the containers. We have Anne, Joel, and Ken. All of them have knives for their weapons. So going through it, I should have seen what that sign was going to say. Whenever they're glowing like that, you want to check them to see what the things are. Sometimes you get the little things unlocked, like the little what are they called? Roll locks, basically. So we got 20 experience and 180 food. And here we get to open 3 of the crates because we did the finished the objectives. Food is important for being able to build new structures in the camp, and the experience goes toward the characters to level them up and stuff. So I don't remember if I did it or not, but I may have put some Halloween bats into the video here for Halloween. They're kind of hard to miss though, so I'll have to check again when I add my voiceover onto this video. And I may be able to add some bats in a little bit later, see if you can spot them and tell me if you did in the comments below. It was a fun little thing I figured I'll do for the Halloween October and everything, so give a little bit of I cannot think of the word right now. That often happens, as you know. Anyways, we're in camp right now. The campfire is where you do the missions. Training grounds, you level up your people. And there's the healer's tent, which when your characters are heavily damaged, when you get back to the camp, they'll go straight there and heal up a little bit. It takes time though for them to do so. In that case, you want to go ahead and switch them out with a different character so that you can go on to the missions again. And the little green things in the middle up there, that little fuel cans, that's your energy, and when you run out, you're not able to do missions anymore. So the word I was thinking of earlier is interactive. That's what I was trying to say, is see if you can find the beds, and I did that. So the video can be a little bit more interactive. Anyway, back to the battles. So if you notice the little things off to the right hand side, the little pot, the orange thing, I think I may have left some of that in, but not all of it. I edited that part out because it took so long for the loading screen to finish. As you can see, I'm going through the boxes there, and they give you each a lock, because that's your prerogatives to get those. And as you unlock them, you can get really good stuff like the gold 3-star. I think there's a 4-star as well. And already off to the second one. First battle in the video, that's I think just a training one, and then the rest of them after that is part of the missions. And here we get Ricardo. He uses blunt weapons like bats and stuff. And the bats, if you use them against the walkers or the other people, that has a ability to stun them for one turn. In here I'm just swapping out Joel with Ricardo. You want to have each character have a different type of weapon. There's the blunt, the stabbing like knives, and then the ranged weapons like arrows, crossbow and guns and stuff. You want one of each in there so cover all your ground. As you can see, Ricardo has stunned the walker, that's what the little yellow thing at the top is, that's spinning around above the walker's head, that looks kind of like a sun. At least to me it looks like that. And it'll get into the special abilities of each character a little bit later in a different video. This is pretty much a tutorial and telling you how to play so you can learn all the basics and get that over with. You receive 2 medical kits. And we're about to get the golden crate. I think that's automatic for each playthrough for this part. And you get a bat. I don't think I actually equipped that to anyone though. I need to do that the next time I play. here we are going off to another battle. And here you can see where it goes up a little bit and see all the walkers behind there. If you go around without stopping first, they can, anyone that is hidden can attack your character. And that thing pops up. Or maybe that's, never mind, it's the Jordan life log thing that just popped up on my screen, which not in the video though. I thought it was part of the video though, because I have it playing as I'm doing the voiceover so I can see what's going on. And they're pretty effective at dispatching the walkers at the moment. And critical hit, as you can see, is something that happens pretty well often though, so to make it easier in battles. Here we get to the difficulty for the walkers, and I think the other survivors would have them also, like the raiders and stuff. So it's always good to get rid of the small numbers first, that way you don't have to worry about them coming after you if you go after the larger numbers first. If it's possible, that is. And you can see they're making quick work of all the walkers here. And a victory. Here you see we have to get rid of those walkers outside the camp and you get supplies and stuff for doing so. Think of them as like little bonus type of things. Yeah, as you can see, we have to use the food in order to place buildings and also upgrade them.